So, before we get started, I'd like to show you some advanced examples of what expressions can do in your project. Use this as an inspiration to kickstart some cool projects in After Effects. This expression calculates the speed of a layer's position change and drives the particle emitter. Here you can see the emission amount changing based on the speed of the emitter's source. Here's a popular expression that automatically calculates a layer's bounce based on the amount of value change. It's great for position and scale properties, but will work on almost any value. This expression automatically fades a layer's opacity based on the layer's distance from the camera. It's useful for flying a camera through a group of 3D layers without having to keyframe each layer's opacity as it passes the camera. Here's a simple countdown clock on a text layer. You can use a slider control to adjust the start time and the countdown speed. And here's an HSL conversion expression that takes an animated luma source and drives a layer's opacity and color fill based on the lightness and RGB value of the input. We've arrived at the end of lesson 102, a showcase for what's possible with expressions. If you enjoy this expressions course, consider purchasing the paid content. It includes in-depth documentation, extra tutorial content, high-definition videos, and all the project files used in the training. Your purchase will help to create more free courses like this in the future.